Hello everyone, welcome to PharmaRocks YouTube channel. In today's video, we will discuss about the syllabus of GPET exam. Okay, and this is the latest updated GPET syllabus from year 2018 and 2019. So, here is the GPET 2019 syllabus was given by a national testing agency. Okay, it is called NTA. So here is the syllabus. The first one is from a physical chemistry subject. Okay, so in the physical chemistry you have to study about the composition and physical states of a matter. Second one is a colligative properties. Next is a thermodynamics. So you have to study about the law of thermodynamics. Okay, then next one is the refractive index. Okay, next one is the refractive index. So in refractive index, about the specific refractivity, molar refractivity and refractometer. Then next one is the solution. Okay, from the solution mainly you have to study about the solubility, factors affecting of solubility, solubility curves, solubility expressions. Okay, so hame pata hai ki jo solution ke andar hum jo padhte hai, normality hai, molarity, molarity, परसेंटेज वेट बाय वेट, वेट बाय वॉल्यूम, मोल फ्रैक्शंस वगैरह जो आता है वो सॉल्यूशन चैप्टर में आएगा. नेक्स्ट जो है आपका सिक्स, इट इज़ ए इलेक्ट्रोकेमिस्ट्री. इलेक्ट्रोकेमिस्ट्री यू हैव टू स्टडी अबाउट द लॉ ऑफ वेरियस इलेक्ट्रोकेमिस्ट्री लाइक फेराडेज लॉ, इलेक्ट्रॉन ट्रांसपोर्ट. ओके, इलेक्ट्रिकल सेल, सिंगल इलेक्ट्रोड पोटेंशियल, हाफ सेल, हाफ सेल पोटेंशियल, type of the cell. Okay, extra you have to study. Then most important from there is a Nernst equation and a salt bridge. Nernst equation and a salt bridge is a important from that portion. Next you have to study, that is a next topic, it is a ionic equilibrium. Ionic equilibrium is an important topic. In that, the theory of conductivity, equivalent conductance and the mobility of ions are important. Next is a kinetic study, order of reactions, derivative and a internal form of rate laws and molarities of a reaction and derivative of rate constant. So this is all about from a subject physical chemistry. Next important subject is a physical pharmacy. Okay, next syllabus is given for a subject physical pharmacy. So in that physical pharmacy, first one is the matter and properties of matter, matlab ki states of matter wala jo chapter jo hai. Okay, ki states of matter, change in the states of matter, latent heat, sublimation, critical point, eutectic mixture, gases, aerosol, extra are important from this. Then also the crystalline, what is crystalline substance, what are the amorphous, what are the polymorphism, okay, etc. are important from a matter of state or states of matter. Next important topic is a micromeritics and powder rheology. Micromeritics and a powder rheology. Okay, so this is a very important chapter in which you have to study about the micromeritics and powder rheology, like the particle size and particle size distribution, average particle size and the weight distribution, particle number. Okay, then powder rheology study, like in that bulk density, depth density, hoarseness ratio, angle of repose, etc. you have to study. Next one important is a surface and interfacial phenomenon. Okay, so that chapter is a surface tension. Okay, surface and interfacial phenomenon. In that you have to study the interface, types of interface, surface free energy and HLB classification, spreading coefficient, okay, etc. Then next chapter is a viscosity and rheology. Okay, viscosity and rheology, in that Newtonian system, non-Newtonian system, okay, flow of various law of the flows, kinematics of the viscosity, various viscometers used to measurement. Okay, next is about the dispersion system. Okay, so colloidal dispersion system, suspension and a emulsion. So you have to make the detailed study about the colloidal dispersion, suspension and emulsion for a
this topic. The next topic is a complexation. Okay, so in that classification of complexes, then in next chapter it is a buffer. Okay, so pH and buffer. Okay, so buffer equation, buffer capacity, buffer pharmaceutical system, preparation and stability of buffer isotonic solution, it is a important one. Next topic is a solubility. Okay, so in the solubility you have to study about the same topics as we have discussed in a physical chemistry. No more difference in that. Okay, next topic is a organic chemistry. Next subject is a organic chemistry. This is a key substance and key subject for a GPAT exam. Okay, ki GPAT ke andar organic chemistry mein se bhi bahut sare questions puche jaate hai. So organic chemistry is a key substance for GPAT exam preparation. So let's check the syllabus of organic chemistry. The first one are the general principle. All the general principle involve in a organic compounds. Okay, review and classification and source of organic compound, sp3, sp2, sp hybridization, sigma and pi bonds, okay, etc. Then an overview of the bond polarization, hydrogen bonds, inductive effects, resonance, hyperconjugation, okay, etc. is covered in a general principles involved in a organic chemistry. The next is a different class of the compounds. Okay, so this is a very important one. Different classes of compound, their IUPAC name, systemic nomenclature, industrial and laboratory methods of preparations of a alkane, alkyne, alkynes, aliphatic, hydroxyl compound, alkyl halides, aldehyde and ketone, carboxylic acid and all functional derivatives of carboxylic acid. Okay, next is a protection and deprotection of a groups. Okay, in that, introduction to production, protection and deprotection of functional groups are covered. Next topic is a aromaticity and chemistry of a aromatic compound. In that, Huckel's rule used to determine the aromatic and non-aromatic characters of a compound. Okay, it is a very important Huckel's rule. Next chapter is a different aromatic classes of a compound. पर उसके पहले एक टॉपिक ही आता है कि रिएक्टिविटी एंड ओरिएंटेशन इन दिस रिएक्शंस लाइक ए सब्स्टिट्यूशन रिएक्शन, इलेक्ट्रोफिलिक एंड न्यूक्लियोफिलिक एरोमेटिक सब्स्टिट्यूशन रिएक्शंस आर ए वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इन ए ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री. देन डिफरेंट एरोमेटिक क्लास ऑफ कंपाउंड लाइक एरोमेटिक हाइड्रोकार्बन्स, फिनोलिक कंपाउंड्स, एरोमेटिक एंड एलिफेटिक एमाइंस, डायजोनियम सॉल्ट्स एक्सेट्रा आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. देन नेक्स्ट इज ए polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbons, okay, their synthesis and rings like a naphthalene, anthracene and phenanthrene. Then carbonyl chemistry, okay, in a carbonyl chemistry various rearrangement reactions you have to study like Wolff-Kirchner reduction, reduction of aryl sulfyl, Bamford-Steven reaction, Mitchell addition, DCC oxidation, Robinson's annulation. Then the famous are Curtis and Wolff Lozenz arrangement, Beckmann rearrangement, Beyers Willinger rearrangement, Pinakol-Pinakolon rearrangement. These are the very important for a GPAT exam. Okay, next is a heterocyclic chemistry. In that you have to study about the various heterocyclic compounds like a heterocyclic ring containing oxygen, sulfur and nitrogen atoms. For example, furan, okay, pyridine, etc. Next is a bridge rings. Okay, bridge ring system and nomenclature. The next topic is about the kinetic and thermodynamic control. Then stereochemistry is a very important topic for a GPAT exam. Then carbohydrates, amino acids and a protein, pericyclic reactions are important for that. In the pericyclic reactions, the concept of HOMO and LUMO is a very important. So this is about the organic chemistry. Next is the pharmaceutical chemistry like a inorganic chemistry in first. So in organic chemistry, you have to study about the impurities in a pharmaceutical substance and sources type and effect of impurities like the limit test. Okay, जो लिमिट टेस्ट है वो बहुत ही इम्पोर्टेंट टॉपिक है, उस पर हम शॉर्ट टाइम में ही आपके लिए एक वीडियो बनाने वाला है कि लिमिट टेस्ट फॉर ए हैवी मेटल्स लाइक ए लेड, आयरन, आर्सेनिक, मर्क्यूरी एंड फॉर क्लोराइड एंड सल्फेट एज एन एज पर द इंडियन फार्माकोपिया. नेक्स्ट आर द मोनोग्राफ्स, आइसोटॉप्स, ओके, डेंटिफ्रायस, डिसेंसिटाइजिंग एजेंट एंड एंटीगेरिज एजेंट फॉर फ्रॉम इनऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री. नेक्स्ट इज अ मेडिसिनल केमिस्ट्री, फ्रॉम द मेडिकेम यू हैव टू स्टडी द थेरापिटिक क्लासेज ऑफ द ड्रग्स. ओके, सो जनरल एनास्थेटिक, लोकल एनास्थेटिक, डायग्नोस्टिक एजेंट, कोएगुलेंट्स, एंटीकोएगुलेंट्स, एंटीसेप्टिक, डिसइनफेक्टेंट्स, स्टेरिलेंट्स, एस्ट्रिंजेंट, पर्गेटिव, लैक्सेटिव एंड एंटीडायरियल ड्रग. देन वेरियस क्लासेज ऑफ थेरापिटिक एजेंट्स फ्रॉम एंटी मलेरियल, एंटी वेमोबिक, एंथलमेटिक्स, एंटी बैक्टेरियल सल्फा ड्रग्स, क्यूनोलोन, एंटी माइक्रो बैक्टेरियल, एंटी फंगल, एंटी वायरल, एंटी अल्सर, हाइपोग्लाइसेमिक एजेंट्स एक्सेट्रा. देन ऑल्सो द सेडेटिव, हिप्नोटिक्स. सो मेन द कॉलोजी रिलेटेड ऑल द टॉपिक्स, बट इन दैट यू हैव टू स्टडी अबाउट द SAR, देर IUPAC नेम, नॉमेन कल्चर, ओके, एंड स्ट्रक्चर, एक्टिविटी, रिलेशनशिप, इट इज मोर इम्पोर्टेंट. सो लेट्स कम इन ए फार्मास्यूटिक्स पर्सन. सो इन ए फार्मास्यूटिक्स, फर्स्ट अबाउट द फार्मेसी एंड प्रोफेशन एंड इंट्रोडक्शन टू द फार्मास्यूटिक्स, देन इंट्रोडक्शन टू द डोजेस फॉर्म. सो वॉट आर द डोजेस फॉर्म यू हैव टू स्टडी इन फार्मेसी, देन नोवेल ड्रग डिलीवरी सिस्टम, न्यू ड्रग डिलीवरी सिस्टम्स आर इम्पोर्टेंट, देन सोर्स ऑफ ड्रग इन्फॉर्मेशन. ओके, सो फ्रॉम वेयर द यू गेट द इन्फॉर्मेशन अबाउट द ड्रग्स. सो दे आर द इंडियन फार्माकोपिया, ब्रिटिश फार्माकोपिया, ESP एंड अदर ऑफिशियल मोनोग्राफ्स. देन एलोपैथिक डोजेस फॉर्म लाइक वेरियस एरोमेटिक वाटर, सीरप, एलिक्सर, लिंटस, लोशन, लिनिमेंट, ओके, सॉल्यूशंस, ENT प्रिपरेशन, मिक्सचर, पेंट, माउथ वॉश, गार्गल्स एक्सेट्रा इन ए एलोपैथिक डोजेस फॉर्म. देन क्रूड एक्सट्रैक्ट लाइक द इन्फ्यूजन, डिकोशन, मैसरेशन, पर्कोलेशन, टिंचर आर ए इम्पोर्टेंट. देन एलर्जेनिक एक्सट्रैक्ट्स, टाइप ऑफ एलर्जन्स, प्रिपरेशन ऑफ एक्सट्रैक्ट, टेस्टिंग, स्टैंडर्डाइजेशन ऑफ एक्सट्रैक्ट्स एक्सेट्रा. देन बायोलॉजिकल प्रोडक्ट्स आर इम्पोर्टेंट फ्रॉम दैट, द एब्सॉर्बेबल एंड नॉन एब्सॉर्बेबल मटेरियल, शटर्स एंड लिगेचर्स, ओके, देयर स्टरिलाइजेशन. देन फार्मास्यूटिकल प्लांट लोकेशन एंड लेआउट इज ऑल्सो इम्पोर्टेंट टॉपिक. देन डोजेस फॉर्म नेसेसिटीज एंड एडिटिव्स, पाउडर्स, कैप्सूल, टैबलेट चैप्टर, ओके, द इम्पोर्टेंट. देन द पेरेंटल प्रोडक्ट्स, देर इवेल्यूशंस ऑफ दिस टैबलेट, कैप्सूल एंड अदर डोजेस फॉर्म. ऑल्सो अबाउट द पेरेंटल, सस्पेंजन, इमल्सन, सपोजिटरी, सेमी सॉलिड डोजेस फॉर्म, लिक्विड डोजेस फॉर्म लाइक सीरप, एलिक्सर, स्पिरिट्स, एरोमेटिक वाटर्स. देन मोस्ट इम्पोर्टेंट टॉपिक इज ए फार्मास्यूटिकल एरोसॉल, ओके, प्रोपेलेंट्स टाइप, देयर फॉर्मुलेशन, मैन्युफैक्चरिंग एंड पैकेजिंग, एंड ऑल्सो अबाउट द इवेल्यूशंस. देन ऑप्थाल्मिक प्रिपेरेशंस, देयर फॉर्मुलेशन, कंटेनर्स. देन प्री फॉर्मुलेशन टॉपिक इज अ वेरी इम्पोर्टेंट, ओके. देन स्टेबिलिटी ऑफ फॉर्मुलेशन प्रोडक्ट्स, सो देयर स्टेबिलिटी स्टडी, हाउ टू मेक द एक्सेलरेटेड स्टेबिलिटी स्टडी, द ह्यूमिडिटी टाइप्स. देन प्रोलॉन्ग एक्शन फार्मास्यूटिकल लाइक द सस्टेन रिलीज, कंट्रोल रिलीज प्रोडक्ट, नोवेल ड्रग डिलीवरी सिस्टम इज इम्पोर्टेंट. देन GMP एंड इट्स वैलिडेशन, पैकेजिंग, मटेरियल, कॉस्मेटिक टॉपिक, ओके. सो इन द पैकेजिंग, द मटेरियल्स यूज इन ए पैकेजिंग लाइक ग्लास, प्लास्टिक एंड रबर, मेटल पेपर, ओके, वेरियस पैकेजिंग मटेरियल्स यूज इन ए पैकेजिंग. देन चाइल्ड रेजिस्टेंट एंड पिल्फर प्रूफ पैकिंग, देन टेम्पर प्रूफ पैकेजिंग आर इम्पोर्टेंट. देन कॉस्मेटिक एंड देयर क्लासिफिकेशन, ओके, कॉस्मेटिक्स यूज इन ए वेरियस वे लाइक कॉस्मेटिक्स फॉर हेयर, कॉस्मेटिक्स फॉर स्किन, लोशंस एक्सेट्रा. नेक्स्ट इम्पोर्टेंट सब्जेक्ट इज ए फार्माकोलॉजी. इन द फार्माकोलॉजी, इट इज़ ए जनरल फार्माकोलॉजी, ओके, इन दैट ऑल द टॉपिक्स कवर इन ए जनरल फार्माकोलॉजी. देन न्यूरोहॉर्मोनल ट्रांसमिशन एंड ऑटोनोमिक एंड सेंट्रल नर्वस सिस्टम, फार्माकोलॉजी ऑफ पेरिफेरल नर्वस सिस्टम, फार्माकोलॉजी ऑफ सेंट्रल नर्वस सिस्टम, देन फार्माकोलॉजी ऑफ कार्डियोवास्कुलर सिस्टम यू हैव टू स्टडी इन ए डिटेल. देन drugs acting on urinary system, drugs acting on respiratory, endocrine are important for a GPAT exam. The most important is a chemotherapy and antibiotic portion you have to cover, then notocoids and their antagonists, then pharmacology of a drugs acting on the GI tract. Next important is a chronopharmacology and immunopharmacology is important. Then this is a very important topic, number 14, it is a vitamin and minerals. Okay, so number of questions asked from a vitamin deficiency disease, their management, role of minerals in a health and disease. Then principle of toxicology and toxicology study is important topic. Next subject is a pharmacognosy. So the best way to study the pharmacognosy is the one is important book. It is a C.K. Kokate book. It is very important for you to cover the topics of the introduction of pharmacognosy, classification of good drug, then factors affecting on quality of good drugs like factors like mutation, polyploidy, hybridization, okay, etc. Then techniques in microscopy, introduction to phytoconstituents, then principle of plants like algae, fungi, gymnosperms, and angiosperms. Then next is the pharmaceutical aids, animal products, plant products, toxic drugs, enzyme, natural pesticides, insecticide, adulteration and evaluation of a crude drugs. Then quantitative microscopy is important, then biogenetic pathways, carbohydrates and lipid containing drugs, then tannin, volatile oil containing drugs. Here giving the in example, you have to study the BSCC use, chemical constituent, then geographical study, allied drugs, substitutions. You have to study up all class of these drugs like resinous, glycoside, tannin, alkaloid. Okay, so this is about from cognosy. At last, you have to study the extraction and isolation technique, phytopharmaceuticals, quality control and standardization of herbal drugs, then herbal formulation, worldwide trades of a crude and drug and volatile oils. Herbal cosmetics is a very important topic for GPAT exam, then traditional herbal drugs. Okay, so then next is a plant-based industrial and research institutes in India. Knowledge about the herbal product being manufacturing by premium herbal industries and a thrust area of the institution involved in a plant research. Okay, so jo herbal ke upar research karte wo institute aapko find karni hai aur uske related aapko yaad rakhna hai their locations and their function. Then about the patents, ayurvedic system of the medicines like a kavath, okay, vatika, churn, asav, aristas and gruta, then various tailas and lep, then homeopathic system of medicines and their use. Next is the pharmaceutical analysis, and from the analysis you have to study the acid based titration, okay, important quality controls in a pharmacy, then non aqueous titration, oxidation reduction titration. Okay, so all the titration from a analysis. Okay, next is the precipitation titration, complexometric titration are a important topic, gravimetric analysis, extraction techniques, potentiometry, methylation methods, like these are the very important, like a diazotization titration, Zindal method, Karl Fischer titration and oxygen flask combination method. These are the very important for a GPAT. Then general principle of the spectroscopy, all the spectroscopy like UV, like flame photometry, atomic absorption spectroscopy, IR, proton nuclear magnetic resonance like a proton, then NMR, mass spectroscopy, polarography, nephelometry and turbidometry, chromatography techniques, and some miscellaneous topics are important from a analysis. Then next is from a biochemistry. Biochemistry ka jo syllabus diya hai GPAT and TNA, so it is a first chapter, it is a cell, then carbohydrate related you have to study, and the best book is a U Satyanarayan book. Okay, so must prefer the Satyanarayan book for a biochemistry and prefer the chapter like a cell, carbohydrates, protein, lipid, vitamins, biological and oxidation reductions, enzyme topic, nucleic acid, and a vitamin chapter. Next is a hereditary disease is a important from a biochemistry. Next subject is a biotechnology. In that you have to study the plant cell and tissue culture. Plant cell and tissue culture is important from a biochemistry. Then animal cell culture, fermentation, DNA technology like recombinant DNA technology, okay, is important. Then polymerase chain reactions are important from this section, okay. Then hybridoma technology, ELISA, etc. from a biotechnology. Then next important subject is a microbiology. From microbiology, you have to study about the introduction like a scope and application in a pharmacy. Then Whitaker's five kingdom concept is important. Then contribution of Ewan Hawke, Robert Koch, Jenner, Louis Pasteur and Ehrlich. Then microscopy and staining techniques, gram positive, negative bacteria, what is capsule, endospore, etc. Microbiological terms. Then biology of microorganisms is important. Then fungi and viruses. Okay, then aseptic techniques. Then this is a very important type chapter. It is a sterilization and disinfection is the most important chapter to study for GPAT exam. Okay, so six number chapter you never skip for GPAT exam. Okay, so the sterilization concept, its classification, principle, method of sterilization, mechanism of cell injury, construction, working, application of moisture sterilization, dry heat, gamma radiation sterilization, filtration sterilization, indicators of sterilization, all are important topics like the D value, Z value, etc. Microbiology spoil is vaccine and sera topic is important. वैक्सीन में से हर साल क्वेश्चंस पूछे जाते हैं. तो वैक्सीन इज़ ए वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक लाइक ए बीसीजी वैक्सीन, डीपीटी, कॉलेरा, टीएबी, ओके. देन माइक्रोबायोलॉजिकल एसे यू हैव टू स्टडी अबाउट दैट. देन न्यू टॉपिक इज इंक्लूडेड इन द जीपेट सिलेबस. इट इज़ ए सब्जेक्ट पैथोफिजियोलॉजी. फ्रॉम पैथोफिजियोलॉजी बेसिक प्रिंसिपल ऑफ ए सेल इंजरी एंड एडेप्टेशन, बेसिक मैकेनिज्म ऑफ इन्फ्लेमेशन एंड रिपेयर, disorder of fluid electrolyte and acid base balance, disorder of homeostatic white blood cell and lymphocyte tissue and red blood cell related to disease. Then immunopathology includes the amyloidosis. Okay, so here are the many various topics are given in that. So Harshmohan book is the best for the pathophysiology study. The infectious disease, neoplastic disease, various diseases you have to study. And in the latest Pharmacy Council of India syllabus also contain the pathophysiology subject in a semester 3. So those are in a semester 3 must concentrate in this subject. It is a very important subject for a GPAT point of view. Okay. Next is a biopharmaceutics and pharmacokinetics. Okay, so from biopharm you have to study about the various ADME, okay, pharmacokinetic, pharmacodynamic study, then bioavailability and bioequivalence study, IVIVC, okay, then BCS classifications of a drug, biopharmaceutical statistics. Then next subject is a clinical and clinical pharmacy and therapeutics. It is an important subject. Various case studies are important from clinical pharmacy. Then this is a new subject. It is a human anatomy and physiology. So from anatomy, you have to study the cell physiology, the blood chapter, gastrointestinal tract related, respiratory system, autonomic nervous system, sense organ, skeleton system, central nervous system, urinary system, endocrine, reproductive, cardiovascular and lymphatic system. So GPAT syllabus is very complex and they have designed as per the BPharm syllabus, which is cover the semester 1 to 8, and the latest Pharmacy Council of India syllabus is cover the this all topics given in a GPAT 2019 updated syllabus, which will be applicable from this year GPAT 2019. Next is a pharmaceutical engineering, in that you have to study the fluid flow, heat transfer, evaporation chapter, distillation, drying. You must have to clear the concept about the size reduction and size separation, extraction chapter, mixing, crystallization, filtration and centrifugation, dehumidification and humidity control are important from engineering subject. Then also the refrigeration and air conditioning, material construction, automated process control system, industrial hazard and safety precautions. So you all have covered this subject in a semester 1 and 2. So from basic, it is very important to cover such subjects. Then this is important and new in this GPET syllabus. It is a pharmaceutical management. So you have to study about the introduction to the management, planning and forecasting. Then Henry Foyle's 14 principle, you must have to study about for the GPET exam. Then planning and forecasting, organizing, research and management, inventory management, communication, marketing research, leadership and motivation, then HRD, human research and development, how it occurs, okay? So this is important from a management. Then GATT era, World Trade Organization, TRIPS, okay? You have to study about the intellectual property rights, and also study about the patent, what is copyright, okay? So then you have to study about the well-known organizations like what is a Bureau of Indian Standards, it is a BIS, then International Organization for Standardization and their values like ISO. Recent mein humne aapke liye ISO par se video already bana kar diya hai. Then WHO, ICH guidelines, then CDESCO, it is a regulatory agency of India and United States. Food Drug Administration, US FDA, is a regulatory agency of a USA. So standard institution and regulatory authorities aapko padhna hai. Us pe bhi hum aapke liye ek video lekar aayenge. Then important subject is a pharmaceutical jurisprudence. Okay, so all the acts you have to cover from a jurisprudence like Pharmacy Act, background, Drug and Cosmetic Act, Narcotic Drug and Psychotropic Substance Act, Drug and Magic Remedy, Medical and Toilet Preparation, MTP Act, Medical Termination of Pregnancy Act, Prevention of Cruelty to Animal Act, Drug Price Control Order, Shops and Establishment, Factory Act, Consumer Protection Act, Indian Pharmaceutical Industry, okay? Then regulatory bodies like BIS, ASTM, ISO, TGA, US FDA, ओके सो ये जितने भी सब्जेक्ट इसमें से आपको सिर्फ बेसिक ही याद रखना है, ऐसा नहीं कि बहुत सारा सिलेबस ऐसा कुछ नहीं है. दीज आर द मेन टॉपिक्स दे हैव गिवन टू फोकस ऑन देयर बेसिक ओनली. आपको रेगुलरली सेमेस्टर स्टडी के अंदर आपको ये सब्जेक्ट का बेसिक जो है वो मेनली कवर करना है. देन नेक्स्ट इंपॉर्टेंट इज डिस्पेंसिंग एंड हॉस्पिटल फार्मेसी. ओके सो डिस्पेंसिंग फार्मेसी में से आपको जो डिस्पेंसिंग जो करते हो आप, कंपाउंडिंग एंड डिस्पेंसिंग लाइक मिक्सचर, सॉल्यूशन, इमल्सन, लोशन, लिनिमेंट, पाउडर, ग्रेन्यूल, सपोजिटरी, ऑइंटमेंट, पेस्ट, क्रीम, इनकम्पेटिबिलिटी स्टडी, वो सब जो है वो काफ़ी इंपॉर्टेंट है. ओके देन रीडिंग एंड काउंसलिंग ऑफ ए प्रिस्क्रिप्शन फ्रॉम ए क्लिनिकल प्रैक्टिस, वो रहेगा हॉस्पिटल फार्मेसी में से. ओके सो रिकमेंडेशन ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड रेफरेंस बुक फॉर द फार्मास्यूटिक्स. ओके हियर इज द लिस्ट गिवन for subject pharmaceutics. They have given the pharmaceutics book. Okay, so here you can check the list of around 14 reference book of a pharmaceutics. Here is the another one till the 24. Then next is here list about the pharmaceutical chemistry and medchem. They have given the standard books. First one is the Morrison and Boyd, then Allerphenol. So must make the habit of using this book, standard books, reference book from a semester 1, so you can cover the whole GPET syllabus with your semester study. Here is the recommended book for the analysis, and then the top it is a Dr. B.K. Sharma, Goel Publishing House, then Dr. B.K. Sharma book, then H.H. Wizard, D.L. Pavia are the inventor book, then Silverstein, John R. Dyer, very famous book for analysis. Next is for a Human anatomy, physiology, pathology, and pharmacology, it is Rangendale. Okay, Rangendale's pharmacology, Goodman Gilman. Okay, then other you can also cover from the Indian author like a Dr. C.K. Kokate book, Lipin Codes pharmacology are the very famous book from that. Also the Satoshkar book, R.S. Satoshkar, very famous books from a India, also in a pharmacology. Then reference book for pharmacognosy is the first one is Thomas Edwards Wallis. Next is a important, it is from Indian author, it is a C.K. Kokate book, very famous book. Okay, so you can cover this topic from that. Then reference book for marketing management, it is a marketing management by Philip Kotler. Reference book of biochemistry, mainly you can cover the Indian author book, it is a U. Satyanarayan book. And microbiology, it is a Pelzar, and also the Tortora you can cover from microbiology. So this is all about the GPAT 2019 updated syllabus. Okay, from this year this syllabus will be continue. So must do the preparations from the basic and keep the confidence to cover the whole syllabus. All the best friend, good luck.